Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube class. Today I am going to explain two very important concepts of national income which are frequently used, that is normal residence and domestic territory. So the definition of normal resident is given as: normal resident refers to the nationals and non-nationals living in a country for more than 1 year and their economic interest lies in that country. So here some important things are to be noted, that normal residence refers to the nationals and non-nationals of a country. That means when we talk about normal resident, it includes both nationals and non-nationals. In case of India, normal resident of India means all the Indian nationals and non-nationals of India who are living in India for more than a year and earning an income in our country. So they will be normal resident of India. Now I am going to explain the components, or what you can say, the elements of normal residents that are included. And if we know the elements, then we will get a clear understanding of normal residents, who are normal residents of a country. And I think if you follow this table or the elements that I have included here, all your doubts, all your confusions will be over. So you see here, first one is, it includes, normal resident includes both individuals. It includes the individuals as well as institutions. So when we talk about individuals, it refers to the factor owners, that is owner of land, labor, capital, entrepreneur. That is all the households will be coming under individuals. And institutions, when we talk about institutions, it refers to the farms or the production centers. So a normal resident doesn't mean only the residents, the individuals. It includes both the individuals as well as the farms, that is the production units. Second one is, it includes, normal resident includes the students, patients and tourists living abroad. For example, if I take example of our country, India, so Indian students, or you can say Indian patients or Indian tourists who are living our country and staying abroad for more than 1 year, they will also be considered as normal residents of our country. Now you can ask me why. The answer is, both these students, patients and tourists, even though they are living abroad for more than 1 year, but their economic interest is not lying in that particular country where they are living. Rather, their economic interest lies in our country. So they will be normal resident of our country, that is, they will be the normal resident of India. The moment the student will start earning there, then they will fulfill the criteria of NRI. Then they will become non-resident Indians, because, and they will no more be a normal resident of India, because they are living abroad for more than 1 year and earning income. So they should not have any economic interest. So long they do not have any economic interest in that country, they will be normal resident of our country. The next point is, people working in embassies and consulates abroad, people working in Indian embassies and consulates in rest of the world, they will also be normal residents of our country. Because these people, Indian nationals who are working in Indian embassy in any of the country in the world, or in the consulate, Indian consulate, so they will be normal resident of our country. Because even though they are staying there for more than 1 year, but their economic interest lies in our country. Government of India will pay their salary. They do not have any economic interest there. They are working on behalf of Government of India. So they will be considered as normal resident of our country. The next point is, the people working in aircrafts, Indian aircrafts or military bases, say peacekeeping forces, whatever it may be, military bases or ships or oil rigs and other floating vessels, whoever is working there and staying in the international area or in other countries, all of them will be considered as normal residents of India, because none of these elements have economic interest in those countries. So first thing is that, for very important thing is that, economic interest. If they may be living abroad for more than 1 year, but we should judge, or we should see whether they are having economic interest in that country or not. Since all these people do not have economic interest in those countries,
they are getting salary or earning income from India. So they will be normal residents of our country. Next one is people working in international organizations. People working in international work organizations like IMF, WHO, UNICEF. So when some Indian nationals are working in international organization and staying in any of the foreign countries, or you can say they are living abroad. Suppose one Indian national working in IMF and staying in USA. So he will be normal resident of India. Why so? Because even though he is staying in USA for more than 1 year, but his economic interests do not belong to that particular country. He is getting salary from an international organization. That is the point why they will be considered as normal resident of India. So an Indian national working in any international organization, he may be living in any country in the world, but he will be considered as normal resident of India. That means the people, in short, in relation to other countries, the people who are working in any international organization, they will be the normal resident of their home. The next point is the foreigners crossing the international border and going to some other country, working there for the whole day, and in the evening coming back to their own country. So they will be considered as normal resident of which country? The country where they are working or their home country from where they belong to. Say for example, some Bangladeshi workers, they are crossing border in the morning and coming to India, working for the whole day, and in the evening they are going back to their own country, Bangladesh. So in that case, they will be the normal resident of their home country, that is Bangladesh, north of India. So this is applicable for everywhere. If Indian workers are also going some other country, or any of the nationals crossing their international border and going to some other country and returning back on the same day, they will be the normal resident of their home country. That means they will be the citizen as well as normal resident of their own country, not the country where they are working. So these are the elements of normal residence of a country, and whoever is there, you just have to compare the whether in which category they belong to. If any of these category they satisfy, or any of these conditions they are satisfying, they will be the normal resident of that country. Important component of national income is domestic territory. If we do not have clear concept of domestic territory, it becomes difficult to estimate national income, because which elements are to be included and which are not to be included, there will be some confusion. So the definition of domestic territory is given as follows. You can see here, domestic territory refers to the geographical territory of a country administered by a government within which persons, goods and capital can circulate freely. And this definition was given by United Nations System of National Accounts. So you can see here, domestic territory refers to the geographical territory. This is geographical territory. We can say the political territory also. Geographical territory means political boundary of a country. So when we talk about geographical territory, it is political boundary of a country. We can think about the map of that country and we can have an understanding of geographical territory of a country administered by a government. So here another thing is that it should be controlled by, administered by one government within which persons, goods and capital can circulate freely. Since it is coming under one government or controlled by one government, so it is quite natural that all the factors can move freely from one place to another. Now I am going to explain the other elements which are included in domestic territory of a country. So as I already have mentioned, that domestic territory includes the geographical territory of a country. Besides this, there are some other elements which will be included in domestic territory of a country. The next component is territorial water. So territorial water includes, it can be classified into three categories, that is up to 12 nautical mile, up to 12 nautical mile, up to 24 nautical mile, and up to 200 nautical mile. Up to 12 nautical mile, this is territorial water. And in territorial water, a country is having
full control. That means no other foreign vessels or foreign the movement of foreign ships or water bodies is not permitted within that particular area. It is having full control there. Now, after this 12 nautical mile, there is another 12 miles. That is 12 plus 12 up to 24 nautical miles. This is called contiguous zone. Here, the country is having limited control. In this area, a particular country is having limited control or partial control. Partial control means it is having control within that area, but the foreign vessels or foreign ships can also pass through that particular area with mutual understanding. And the remaining up to 200 nautical now up to 200 nautical mile, that is called exclusive economic zone. Here, that country is having control only on the resources lying underneath with foreign passage. Now, next one is territorial airspace. Even though there is no international agreement regarding the territorial airspace, but still we can consider the flying zone of a country. Generally, the flights fly at a height of 7.5 km to 12 km. So that area is considered as the domestic territory of a country. Because how we can conclude it? Because even though there is no international agreement, but because if any foreign country's flights want to fly and use that particular space, they need to take permission of that particular country. If that particular country do not allow, permit that particular, the neighboring country to use their flying zone, they cannot fly. So we can consider that that is also the territorial airspace of that particular country. Next one is embassies, consulates, military bases located abroad. So Indian embassies, Indian consulates, Indian military bases located abroad, those areas will also be considered as domestic territory of our country. And finally, ships, aircrafts, fishing vessels, oil, natural gas rigs operated by the residents in international water, all these things will be considered as domestic territory of our country, even though these things are floating in the international water. And these are the basic concepts of Ramavisayam and domestic territory of a country. And if you can understand these things properly, then there will be no doubt in understanding in estimating national income for that particular country. Thank you.